So yesterday we discussed a few things, right, about sharing and as well as minimum requirements downloading Windows Server 2019. Okay, so once you are downloaded, you have to install Windows Server 2019. These are the minimum requirement to install. 1.4 gigahertz processor compulsory, 64-bit environment is compulsory. 2 GB RAM is required because of it is a desktop experience. Already I told, if your physical RAM is 4 GB and give the virtual machine 1 GB only. Guys, here we have to run, means after installation of Windows Server, we have to run two things. One is Windows Server and Windows 10. Both are we have to run. So compulsory like that. So 1 GB, 1 GB. So compulsory check the available RAM. Make sure it is more than 2 GB available in a availability RAM. Okay, so for these people, if you are not, so try to upgrade your RAM. Okay, that's very simple. Hard disk minimum requirement is 32 GB. Okay, this is the minimum requirement to start. Next, there is options server core and desktop experience. Server core and desktop experience, two options are there. We are installing desktop experience thing. And two editions are there. Desktop experience means GUI. Server core is like a CLI. Okay. So next, two editions. What are we download? That is contains two editions. Okay. So the which is I showed, that is two editions are there. One is standard and data center. Two editions in the same image. Essentials are separate. Essentials are separate image. Okay. This is in the two images. So we are going to install data center. Or standard, no problem. If you install a standard, also no problem. Okay, but there is no differences. There is a no difference except the number of virtual machines you can able to create it. Anyway, we are using Evolution, so use the data center. That is the thing. Okay, so first of all, I have to create a virtual machine. Then only I can able to create it. Install, right? So first one is I'm going to create a virtual machine. So first of all, minimum requirements. For both the things, same minimum requirements only, so not much differences. Of course, I didn't take what is server, what is the features, guys. Lot of theory is there, that is also we'll discuss. So first of all, we have to create a virtual machine, okay, for Windows Server 2019 in a VMware workstation only I'm using, guys. And people who are unable to work with the VMware workstation, they can use VirtualBox also. Okay, yes, here it is. Point is the network is VMnet 1. Okay, here I'm using VMnet 1. VMnet 1 is a host only type. Is a host only type, and there is a setting. Again, we have to do the setting also. Okay, so host only type, VMnet 1 is a host only type. And so we can communicate other VMs connected to VMnet 1. Okay, like a it's like a switch type. Okay, connected to one. Next, we cannot communicate to physical network, meaning is no internet access. Meaning is no internet access. Also we can connect or communicate to physical machine. We can connect and communicate, or we can communicate to your physical machine, possible, but you cannot communicate outside of the machine network. Okay, no internet access. That is a VMnet one. So this is a like a private or internal network. Yes, it is look like everything Greek and Latin for a starting, but try to habituate it to understand certain words. Why? Because of these are all network virtualization related one that is also in the syllabus. Okay, so whatsoever it is, don't worry about that one. So simply we use VMnet one, that is very important here. Again, create a new virtual machine. For starters, you can use typical or you can use custom, no problem. But in a custom, it will ask so many questions. First of all, I will show you the custom. Then why I'm telling always a typical. See custom, see it is asking which version compatible. Immediately you will get confused like, so what is this option? Okay, operating system later, that is okay. OS is okay, so then you have to select 2019 or 16. Which operating system you are installing? 2019-16. There is no 32-bit kind of stuff. It is a purely 64-bit only. So you have to give the name and location. Again, it is asking BIOS, UEFI, okay, and server options and RAM options, okay, network related. Okay, and SAS logic kind of stuff. Okay, SCSI, new virtual hard disk, how much disk you want to put it. Next, so again, you have to customize the hardware. Same thing only, but initially it is asking some options directly. Okay, so someone put a message or what?
Sir, I'm getting like this, sir.
So why you are getting this one?
Sir, yesterday I installed Windows in VM, sir.
Virtual box or workstation?
Sir?
You install in a...
Not in virtual box, sir. Not in virtual box, sir.
VMware workstation only.
Yes, sir.
Then why it is going to BIOS? So you start a computer, you are getting this one.
Yes, sir.
So go to F10 for a BIOS setup. Go to BIOS setup and check hard disk is there or not like that. Okay. So if you want to change anything, you can do. Don't change anything. Okay. So already virtualization is enabled means don't want to change anything. Okay, so otherwise you can press enter, continue startup. So if you got other issues, please tell me.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so that's it. Okay, guys, that is a custom options. Lot of questions it is asking. So very simple. I'm going with the typical only. Okay, if anything required, I will change it later. No problem. Okay, so then last option. Same thing like your Windows. 10 only, so not much differences. But only thing is certain options will change. Windows Server 2019. Then I will remove this one and I put a Windows WinS1. Name of the virtual machine is WinS1, but I am taking your batch to avoid a confusion. I put a 16. Okay. And where you want to store in a H drive Okay, this is your part, right? So then I remove entirely. Test drive, here I want to store. Then put a slash, copy, paste. Okay, test drive. This is my virtual location. So in this one only, because of I want to store all the virtual machines in this folder only. Within this folder only, I want to store like that. Which is your folder? Based on that, you can do it. But put a name WinS1 for understanding. It is a server. Okay. You can you no need to give CDS16. No problem. Okay. I given a name and I given a location and this location. Next. Single file. Select the single file. This is showing a 60 GB. I put a 160 GB. 60 GB enough. No need to change anything. Just I put a 160 GB. No problem. It is a dynamically expanding. Nothing will happen. Okay. But make sure that at least 30 GB free in your physical drive, physical disk. Okay. So that is again 160 GB single file. Next, customize hardware. Okay. So here I a 2 GB processor 11 and select this option. 2 GB processor 1 and select this option for a nested virtualization. And CD use ISO image file, browse, find out where is your server operating system. My server operating system I downloaded here in this OS folder. Okay. So this is my server operating system name. You can see 177.63.7.37. This is my server operating system. Also you can see server evolution 64-bit. Okay, US. Okay, so this is my operating system. Okay, next adapter custom VM net one. It is a host only type VM net one. Again, memory is 2 GB. Select 11 and select this option. Put the image and VM net one. Network adapter VM net one. That's it. Finish it. Okay. So then edit virtual machine settings. Edit virtual machine settings. Okay. In the edit virtual machine settings, once more verify all are connected or not. Okay. All are connected or not. Next. Go to options tab. Go to advanced. Make sure UEFI is selected. Okay. If UEFI is disabled, like this, it is showing disabled mode. So this is a BIOS only. So no other chance. But better is UEFI if you have. And VMware tools, time sync off, select this option. Synchronize guest time with the host. Okay. No need to select any other options here. Okay. No need to select any other options here. So one is advanced, another is VMware tools. That's it. So editing is completed. Only one thing is adding a three lines. So I'm going to my VM edit file. Already you have that one. Already I shared this file information. Okay. So you have to go to VM directory. Open VM directory. So open with a notepad, scroll down, click on the last. Okay, so click on the last. So then you can see the cursor. Okay, make sure the cursor is there. Okay, if you select somewhere and you try to paste from here, So then it will paste in some different place. So then you will get errors. So click on the last. So scroll down. So make sure it is end of the file. Okay. And so make sure that's a thing like this. So it is very clear. Very clearly you can able to see here. So make sure it is there. Okay, do not type it, guys. If you type also, no problem. But this is V0. V0, not O. It is 0. Save. And close. Okay, this part completed. Now we can start the virtual machine. Okay. Can I start virtual machine? I'm starting a virtual machine. Yeah, I done a mistake. What is the mistake? No, so don't worry. So I have to check my availability RAM is around 5.6 GB. To make it faster installation, I'm going to power off this virtual machine. Okay, just for installation purpose only, I'm increasing the RAM. Guys, I'm checking my current availability RAM. So how much RAM I have, that is secondary. My availability RAM is 5.9, it is showing. So I can give 4 GB RAM for this one for installation purpose. Later I will reduce it. That is the advantage of virtualization, right? So I'm using 2 GB RAM for installation purpose. I increase to 4 GB. I am doing it. You should not do it. You have to keep in 2 GB or 1 GB only. Okay, I'm changing for a 4 GB because I have a free RAM is there, 6 GB is there. So I can use 4 GB. That is a good for me. Just for installation, just power on the virtual machine. And when it is showing, press any key to boot from CD or DVD. You have to immediately press the enter button. And guys, look at here. Already I told last time also, but still some people, confusion is common, guys. Why? Because of it is not your regular job. You are not learning anything from your college days. This is not even a college syllabus also, right? You're not even a regular syllabus. It's not a web browser. So it is new to you. So confusion is common. So listen very carefully. When it is showing like this, hand symbol or an arrow mark. So click on the screen. So take the mouse into center of the black screen. Click it. And if it is showing like this, press Alt Control Delete. Sorry. Alt Control Insert. Alt Control Insert. And press any key to boot from CD DVD and immediately press Enter or a spacebar or any key, ABCD also you can type it. Again, I'm trying to do is look at sharp. Press any key to boot from CD DVD, I press Enter. Now in the bottom you can see loading files. Okay, loading files, Windows logo. Meaning is you're working on it. Okay. Okay, which one? English India. The second option, meaning in the second one, time and currency format. It meaning is English India, meaning is language is English and we are in a India. Time zone is India. Time zone is India. India has a three time zones, but completely they merged into one single time zone. That is Indian time zone only we have. Okay, so time and currency format India. So where is your server? Where is your machine? So that time zone only you have to give. Okay. Based on the location of the machine. Remaining no need to change. Yes. First is English, next is India. So install now. All are same as a Windows 10 only. Only one option is different. So all remaining are same. After installation completed, it reboots. It asks for a password, not a username. Okay, so that is important. Guys, look at here. I'm selecting last one. You can select a second or a fourth one. Second or a fourth. Because I want a desktop experience. You can see desktop experience. Okay. So that is a better is last. Why? Because second confuse by second you select first one or third one. So I put a last one. Okay, I put a last one, and then I will take a one screenshot. I'll share the screenshot also. Very good. Okay, be careful with this thing. Select the last one. Okay, save it. So what to do here, it is server OS select. Okay, so that is important. Remaining are same, so select the last option. Next, accept the license terms. Next, custom only custom because of no voice inside, so you have to select the custom. Okay, and click on a new, apply. Okay, remaining are same, only one is the difference is selecting the operating system, because of it is standard and data center, server core and desktop experience. So select the last one. Okay, and it is a GPT type of partition because of I use UEFI, that's it is a GPT type of partition. So it is splits like this. Next, now it is installation is started. Let it install. If you want, you can go to Shift F10 to go to this part. Again, I'm telling, this is purely optional, guys. You don't need to do it. Okay. So go to Task Manager. And set the priority. I put a priority is real time to increase the speed. Okay, so actually it is won't effective, but it is a hobby. Also, I want to show you disk part. Okay, so disk part is a command for managing disk, like a disk management command. Okay, list disk, how many hard disk you have. It is shows here 160 TB hard disk, and it is a GPT type of hard disk, and it is GPT type of hard disk. I am removing this one, so I am coming out from this. Let it install, it will take time, and once it is completed, it will restart itself. Second, someone's posted another post, some picture, same picture on. No difference. Okay, so let it install, guys. I'm muting for some time. You can also just relax. Okay, I will have some breakfast. Okay. installed. See this one, my availability RAM become 1.7 GB. Still, like I see, the machine is running, 4 GB virtual machine is running, but still I have a 1.6 GB available. So it is good, like a system running, still running good. Okay, so that's the point here. Of course, after installation, okay, after I done all installations and everything completed, what I will do, I will shut down my virtual machine. I reduce the RAM to 4 GB to 2 GB. So then availability RAM will be increases. So always important is availability of RAM. Of course, CPU is also, but it is a 4-core processor. It is i5 world processor. It is 3rd generation. Okay, guys, see, it is username administrator already fixed, so we can't change anything here. Okay, you have to log in as a administrator only, and you have to give the password. Guys, always the password is admin@123. Okay, or give a regular passwords like a Vedic @123, 70s @123, or ABC @BZ, like that something which is you are more habituated, you can give, no problem. But try to give admin@123 only. Why? Because of I telling, you know, you are not touching regularly, means 24 hours you are not working with that machine, right? So if you forget this password, you can't do anything. Okay, you can't crack the password. That is server password. I don't know how to crack it also. Okay, do not forget your password. If you forget the password, just forget anything. Just delete a virtual machine and create a new thing again. Okay, so only that option. So give regular password like admin@123 kind of stuff. Then go for a finish. Okay, this is the finish. Click finish. Okay, again, it will take another maximum 5 minutes. Yeah, it is came. Alt Control Inset, because I'm using VMware workstation. For Alt Control Delete, Alt Control Inset. And it is asking login, so give the password admin@123 for administrator. Guys, this administrator is a local administrator. Local administrator. Yeah, we got a screen. Okay, finally. Just we have to wait a little bit. So because the server manager will be open. And do not confuse between a Windows server and a Windows client. So you can remember like this Cortana is not showing here. See that there is a no Cortana here. Task view is there, search is there, start button is there. And this is the Microsoft Edge is not showing here. I'm installing 2016 or 2019. Environment is look like a very old one. You have to verify which OS you install. This is a server manager. In the server manager, I'm muted. Can I able to hear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I thought, sir. I forget to unmute it. Very good. Okay. So this is 2019 data center only I installed. So no confusion at all. Okay. So actually, I have a lot of operating system in same place. So sometimes we will get confused. No problem. Actually, no confusion. I know, but so better see. So this is a screen size. Can you see the screen size is very less? So this is 800 into 600 screen size, very basic screen. Okay, if you put a depends upon your screen, you can increase it. So based on that, it increases, but not required anyway. So not now. So just wait. This is a local server, guys. This is server manager. To manage the server, your server. Okay, this is very useful, server manager. If in case in your network you have a 10 servers, all 10 servers can be managed from this single server manager also. I said no, server core is there, nano servers are there. So if you want to manage those servers also, you can manage from this single server manager. So server manager can manage multiple servers from single window. Okay. Local server means it's about our server only. About our server. This is a computer name, means my server computer name. I'm in a work group. Okay. My Windows Defender. And I got an IP address. Okay. So it is not showing IP address because of it is assigned by DHCP. It is showing like that. So I'm going to my IP address. I will ask one question. So can you able to see this IP address 169.254.30.97?
Yes, sir.
So this is APIPA address, automatic private IP address. APIPA. Automatic private AP. IP. AP IPA. AP. IPA, okay, automatic private IP address. If you are not unable to get IP address from DHCP server, if you are unable to get IP address from DHCP server, system will assign IP address to itself. That is called a APIPA address in the range of 169.254 network range. That is, we will see in a DHCP practical. So currently, so this is your server. To add any roles, manage, add roles and features. Okay. So next. These are the roles. So when you have a time, just go through once, one by one role, and read the description also. What are the roles are there? If you don't understand certain role, no problem. So try to get it. So this is a combination is also there. It's in a file storage. Having internal roles also there. Next one is features. Next one is features. Different type of features are there. Just look at it. That's it. Okay. So I cancelled it. This is about your server installation, guys. So two things I want to tell before I close it. One is edit. Virtual network editor. Okay, go to edit. Virtual network editor. Okay. Then wait. See, this is happened, right? So virtual network editor, VM net one, host only, connected, DHCP not enabled. See, in a host, in VM net two, DHCP enabled, but VM net one, DHCP not enabled. So what to do? What to do means how to get like that? So you don't want DHCP. So change settings. Then it will be open. See, it is. This is VMNet 0. This is VMNet 1 host only. Normally for your system, it shows like this. In your system, it shows like this. VMNet 1 host only connected, enabled like this. What to do? You can see use DHCP service to distribute IP address. Unselect this one. Unselect this one. Okay, unselect this one. So this is your VMNet 1 setting. So make sure that VMNet 1 should be disabled, DHCP disabled. Remaining is same, host only, connect, and second one is uncheck. Okay, otherwise what happened, the DHCP will give you IP address that's confuse your network. So important is, this is uncheck it. Okay, and this is not enabled. Okay. VMNet 1, this is, in this condition, it should be there. Okay, so that is the important one. Okay, so then, so click OK, apply OK kind of stuff. So what to do? So VMNet 1, unselect this option and apply OK. So that is a VMNet 1 setting. That is the first one. Second one, after installation of operating system, install the drivers. This is a VMware workstation, install VMware tools. So click on install VMware tools. So it is already connected, that's it is showing cancel. Okay, it is showing cancel means it is already connected. Either it will shows a notification here or yes, like this. DVD VMware tools, click there. Run setup 64.exe, you can click here also. Otherwise, go to this PC. If it is not getting, so then go to VMware tools. It is automatically extracting. If it is not extracting, no problem. Just go to setup 64. So double click on it, so it is extract from it, so for preparing installation. You know, when it is installing, what it will do, it extract the package and store in the temporary files. You know, remaining things, just next, complete, select the complete option, next, install.
All are same, sir, just like Windows 10.
Yeah, just like a Windows 10 only. Installation is same as a Windows 10. Only one thing is OS. Only this is same. Okay. That's why I didn't take more time to create a virtual machine and installation.
Sir, this is same for Oracle virtual machine also.
Installation is same. Only virtual machine creation is different. We don't get a VMware tools there. Okay. Internal virtualization, no need to add a three lines. Only that check mark is we have to do it. We If you want, I will show you. I will create a virtual machine and I don't install OS because it will take a lot of RAM. Once it is completed, so to avoid a confusion. Okay. So now the screen is came. Good. Because this machine, virtual machine alone, taking a 4 GB. It is asking for a restart, guys. I don't want to restart. You have to restart it. Okay, click on yes, but I'm not doing it. Okay, click on no, but you have to press yes only. I'm just going to power off this virtual machine because the virtual machine I given 4 GB RAM. Now I don't want that 4 GB. I wanted only 2 GB because I need a more RAM for a client purpose also. So I shut down the virtual machine. So right click like a Windows 10 only, just click here, shut down. It asks a reason why you want to shut down this machine. That's one difference. Again, continue. So whatever it is, other reason, continue. So let it shut down. Okay, initially nothing is there in the Windows server. Okay, no role, nothing is there. It is do very faster. Later it is very slow. Edit virtual machine settings. So click on the, once you shut down, click on edit virtual machine settings. I'm using 4 GB RAM. I change it to 2 GB RAM. Click OK. Now it is 2 GB RAM. So I will use it for next time. It is only 2 GB. Okay. So when I shut down the virtual machine, automatically I can gain the RAM space. Understand, guys? Now availability RAM, earlier it is 1.7 because 4 GB virtual machine is running, automatically 4 GB taken. Now it is 6. One second. So this is how to create a machine, but I will try to show you in a VMware VirtualBox also, just how to create a virtual machine and how to do the settings. Okay, so this is already one virtual machine is created, so I'm going to create a new one. Click on a new, put a win yes to. Okay, so select Windows, Microsoft Windows, Windows 2019, 64-bit. It's a 64-bit only, and change the location. Again, locations are important, right? So then usually I want to store all my virtual machines in this location only, right? So then copy, paste in this location, and put another slash, copy the virtual machine name, paste there, okay? And click on a create. It is asking how much disk required. 50 GB is okay because minimum is 32 GB, 50 GB, but I put a 150 GB, no problem. Just click on create. So create it and go to settings again. So here it is. Go to basic. Yes, the same setting only. Advance. You want a bi-directional kind of stuff, put a bi-directionals for drag and drop kind of stuff. And that's it. Go to system. Select UEFI, hardware clock in UTSC kind of stuff. If you don't select also, no problem. Processor. See, enable network virtualization is not there. It's okay, we will enable it. So that's it, okay? That's kind of stuff. Okay, in the system only I selected this option. This is not showing enable. We will enable it. Next is storage. Go to empty, go to empty. Just choose a disk, okay? Then go to where is your operating system stored. That is okay. So this is my OS file. So I inserted. Next is network, host only or internal. Internal also okay, no problem. I put a host only. So virtual box, host only, network adapter will be open. Host only because VMnet one is a host only. These also host only, but both won't communicate each other. So don't worry. Okay. Host only, but is this virtual box host only? That is different host only, that VMware related. So they won't communicate each other. So host only adapter. That's it, nothing to do anything. Just click OK, save settings. Again, we are not getting virtualization enabled kind of stuff, right? So that is the check mark, nested virtualization is not enabling. So what to do? Go to CMD. Okay. The first one is, first of all, we have to go to the file, which is yesterday I saved it. So go to this location, or if you are already added environmental variables, if you added the link into the environmental variables, no problem. Otherwise, go to this link. Okay, CD, this link. Then like this program files, this is the where virtual box is stored. Then run the this command for nested virtualization purpose. Okay, where is a VM hyphen name is there. So there we have to put your server name, means your virtual machine name, enter. Okay, it is not throwing any error, means everything is good, fine. This is also not required. So go to here, edit settings again. Go to system, processor, see, it's got selected. I'm selecting other thing also, NX also I'm selecting, and this is also selected. So make sure that both are selected. So then you'll get a internal virtualization, means nested virtualization means you can install Hyper-V inside. Okay, so that's it. Virtual machine is created. You want to start, you can start. I'm not going to install anything, right? Just I want to show you whether it is booting or not. So normal start only. Remaining settings, you have to understand. Yeah, it is showing some error. If it is showing error, just copy and paste it, then you will understand not found. Internal adapter is not found. So there is a. There is always a headache of this one. So this is there, na? So that is there. No other kind of stuff. So I'll try again. Okay, I will change it. The network adapter from host only to internal adapter. Then no problem. So something INET net is there. Okay, so INET net is there. So I change my internal adapter because it's not starting. Actually, it won't give any problem, but it's giving that problem. Yeah, machine is started. So it is asking for a boot from CD, DVD kind of stuff. Because this notification, it is unable to get it. So here it is. Right side control and delete. Right side control and delete. Again, press any key to boot from CD, DVD. It is showing. So when it is showing, press enter button. Enter button. Now it is loading files. Right side control, guys. The controls are little different. Okay, the first thing. Next one is, I am telling now only because all practicals we do on a VMware only. Okay, so this is a setup. So you can continue same setup only, no differences. Only VMware tools, we don't install it. Just we'll continue this one. If you are using one is a server, another is a client. Okay, one has a server, another is a client. Like this is a server and this is the client. In that cases, go to the client, go to settings. Okay, go to network. Change bridged network to internal network only. Okay, same INIT net is there. Same name only, internal network, because for me, host only is not working. That's why I'm changing to internal network. So INET network. So it is a purely private network. Okay, so now it is, see, look at here. Both are in a same connection. Both are in a same connection. So go to VM, WinC2. There you can find a network. See, internal network, INIT net. This is also internal network, INIT net. Then you can proceed remaining things, just like you can install a Windows server and you can start a Windows client and make sure both are communicating each other or not. Okay, so this is how to install in a VMware. So remaining is same, options are same. You'll get everything is the same only. Again, it will take time, so I don't want to waste your time. Okay, or do you want to show me installation? Same thing, English India install now. No difference, you don't find anything. Voice is a voice only. You install in a physically or virtually, voice is voice only. Only thing is the backend environment is different. Okay, it is not showing install now button, just it is directly showing fourth option. Next. Go to custom. I'm muted or open? I'm open, okay. like this is same thing only, no difference it is. Yeah, that's it guys. Same thing, once it is installed you have to give the password, username, password and okay.
Okay sir.
So anyway, so just take a 10 minutes break. Okay, so take a 10 minutes break, have tea or coffee or something, and we'll continue the another part is like a Windows what is server, different type of servers, what is workgroup, what is domain, how to install a domain controller. Okay, so this kind of stuff we will discuss, and also we'll install a domain controller today only. Okay, that is we will do it. So for that one also I will tell the settings. So Windows client settings also there. So I will tell you the settings. First of all, there is small theory part is there. We'll tell. So take a 10 minutes break. 11:50 or 11:55 maximum. Okay, 11:50 or 11:55. Be back there. I'm stop recording.